All right, so thank you so much for watching the other sections, and now we're going to go over the transformers. So transformer, this section is a lot shorter than the LED bulbs. There's not a lot to a transformer, so essentially the transformer converts the high voltage into low voltage. Now, something that a lot of people don't know about it is transformers will convert it by taking off a zero. So if the outlet is the normal 120 or 120 volts, it will convert it into 12 volts. But if it's 130, it will convert it into 13 volts. 150, it will convert it into 15 volts. So it's not always 12 volts. So that's something that later on you'll be asked to check. But essentially that's what it does. It converts it so that the low voltage can handle the electrical current at a lower voltage. So transformers are most often stainless steel, and they're based on the amount of watts that can handle. So a 60 watt, 100 watt, 120, 150, 300, 600, 900, 120, those are the common ones. And it's just the amount of watts that it can handle. And so most of the time, if you do it this way, you'll be totally fine. If you count up the amount of watts in the installation, and let's say you have 10 lights at 7 watts each, so that's 70 watts. So you would need a transformer that's 100, 120, 150, 300. So you need something that's more than the amount of watts that you have, because if you have a transformer that can produce less, then not all the lights will come on, because the transformer won't be able to handle it. And a good rule of thumb is you don't want to exceed about 75 to 80% of the max capacity of the transformer in wattage. So if you have a 300 watt transformer, don't go up to 300 watts in your lighting system. Come down 20, 25% of that as your max. That way, if there is ever a need to add any lights, or there was just a little bit something finicky about the bulbs, or somebody put in a brighter bulb, whatever, you don't want that max to go over what the transformer can hold. So that's a good rule of thumb, 75, 80% of the max capacity. So inside the transformer, you're gonna wire up the wires. So one side of the wire will go into the commons, and then the other one will go anywhere between the 12 volts and the 15 volts. So once both are in, so one's in the common, one's in one of the other volts, then that wire has electricity coming from the transformer, and then it's going to go to those lights. So you have 12 to 15. So like I'd mentioned before, the transformer converts it into 12 volts, but depending on how long your wire is or how many lights that you have, your lights might need a higher voltage that are way out there, because there's a thing called voltage drop. So the power from the transformer, once it goes all the way to those lights, it loses power as it goes slowly. So when it makes it all the way to the end, it's not going to be a true 12 volts. So if you put it into 12 volts, it might be 11, it might be 10, it might be 8. If you go look at those lights, and just with your eyes, if you can visually tell that those lights aren't as bright, then just move the volt wire over to a higher volt, or all the way to the highest. That way those will turn on a lot brighter. Whereas if a light is really close to the transformer, there's not going to be any voltage drop, and there's no reason to put it on the highest setting, especially if a light bulb can't handle that higher voltage. A lot more professional lights can handle it. There's a thing called a diffuser that can be in some of these bulbs, but that's probably something that you won't deal with as much or at all. If you do, then you'll learn it on your own. But for the most part, keep it around 12 to 13 if the lights are closer to the transformer, and anything farther, put it on a 14 or 15 volt. And for the most part, everything will work out perfectly. So one of the things that you need to make sure that you check is something called amps or amperage. Now that's the power that the transformer is utilizing for electricity. So if you have a high amperage for the transformer, then that means that transformer's working pretty hard and will probably wear out a lot sooner. And a transformer has a certain amount of max amperage that it can handle. So a 300 watt can handle about a 2.5 amperage. And then if you go down to 150, then that is usually about a 1.5 amps. So for a bigger installation, so if you're running a longer wires, even though you have a shorter amount of watts, you might have a higher amperage because that transformer is going to be working pretty hard. And if you're using small wire, like a 16-2 or 14-2 wire for long runs, that transformer is gonna have to work really hard to get that electricity all the way to the end. And so that's why you wanna have a thicker wire, like a 12-2 gauge. And we only use 12-2 gauge unless you're using a spot that's harder to fit wire in, or the wire is going to be really noticeable. We'll go down to a 14 or 16-2, but right now we use all 12-2 gauge because the thicker gauge wire can handle a higher amperage. So it makes it so the transformer is not working so hard. So if you check, so where the photocell ring is, and I'll explain where that is in a second, you need to use your meter to kind of grab it, and it will tell you what the amperage is. So if you have a low amperage, then you're good. The transformer is not working super hard. But if it's a high amperage, then you're gonna have to either put a bigger transformer on there, or you're gonna have to adjust some things. But that is what amperage is, and it's really important, and not a lot of people know about it. All right, so the next thing, inside the transformer, you'll see a plug. Now that's where you plug into, there's a black wire in there. If you plug that in, then the transformer is always connected. Or you can plug in a digital timer or an astronomical timer in there, and that's where it goes. So if you ever are wondering where the timer goes, it plugs into that, and then the black cord plugs into the timer. And so the timer is essentially like a switch. So when it's off, the transformer's off. And then when it's on, the transformer turns on. So that's where that goes. Where the ring is, that's where a photocell goes. So you unplug that and then you put the photocell in, and the photocell will make it so the transformer's on whenever the light, like there's no light outside, it's dark. And photocells are a little interesting because sometimes customers don't wanna have lights on the entire night. Sometimes they do wanna have it on all night. So the last thing inside of the transformer is there's a white or yellow, or sometimes orange. It's a switch with an on and off. And that's kind of like a fail switch. So if there's ever an electrical surge or whatever, something like that, it will shut off. And that's really nice because it used to be in the old transformers, it used to be a fuse. So whenever there was an electrical current, so if you touch the wires, it would trip the switch. But back then, if you touched the wires on accident, then the fuse would break. And then you'd have to replace the fuse instead of just flipping the switch up or down, whichever one is on. And so that feature is really nice. It helps protect your transformer and your lighting system. So last thing about transformers, like I had mentioned before, sometimes you have timers or photocells. So the different things that turn the transformer on are a digital timer, an astronomical timer, and that timer, it's pretty cool because it bases it off of the area that you're in. So every day it adjusts to daylight savings. So whenever it's getting dark or a little bit lighter, it will adjust for you. So those are really cool. Rather than the digital timer, rather than the analog timer, that timer, if the power goes out or anything happens like that, it will stop and you have to constantly adjust it. So some people like doing that. I use that a lot, so that's my go-to timer. I'm probably gonna switch over, but that's what I use, and a lot of companies use that as well. And the last way to do it is through a smart plug. Some people plug in their transformer to their pool equipment and have their pool equipment app control the lights. Sometimes they put a smart plug in there so that they have the app on their phone and they can just control it from their phone. So that's kind of where everything is heading. A lot of people want to have a smart plug for their transformer, whereas it used to be everybody didn't really care as long as the lights were working and they didn't really need the access from their phone. So you'll see on different installs, some customers will want one or the other. So there you go. That's everything you need to know about a transformer. And the next section, I'm going to talk about the different types of wire. And that section is going to be a little smaller because there's not really much to wiring. But thanks for watching this section, and I will see you in the next section. Bye.